This is not a drone shot. It's 30 photos, no video, no motion graphics, just Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Premiere Pro. I wanted to see if I could fake an orbiting hyperlapse using only still photos. So I picked one building in Atlanta and I shot it from every direction across the entire city. The twist is I wanted to make the foreground feel like it's moving, like I'm circling around the building fast. This is where Photoshop came in. The first thing you're gonna do in Photoshop is you're going to duplicate your photo three times. Let's name the bottom layer bottom, the middle layer middle, and the top layer top. Then blind all the other layers except the top layer. And then you're gonna go over to the quick selection tool and you're going to select the building. Then you're going to do Control Shift I to inverse your selection. And then you're gonna click delete. That leaves just the building alone on the top layer. Then you're going to go over to the middle layer and make sure that you blind all the other layers. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go over to the eraser and you're going to erase where your building is currently in the middle layer. After that, you're going to stay clicked on that middle layer. Then you're gonna go over to filter. Then you're gonna go over to blur. Then you're gonna go over to motion blur. And then you're gonna make sure that your blur amount is 173 pixels. Then you're gonna click OK. You're gonna leave the bottom layer as is. So essentially what you have is you're gonna have a bottom layer of which you've done nothing. You're gonna have a middle layer that's gonna be the blurred foreground. And then you're gonna have the top layer, which will be the unblurred building that's gonna remain quote unquote in focus. Now it's time to exit Photoshop and go back into Premiere Pro. Once you're in Premiere Pro, you're gonna go to your folder with all of the photos in it. Then you're going to align them on the timeline. And you're gonna make sure that each of these photos are only one frame across. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna highlight all the photos. Then what I like to do is I like to go over to the properties panel. And if you can't see the properties panel, go over to Windows and make sure that properties is checked. And then I'm gonna go down to transform. Then I'm gonna go to fill just to make sure that each of these photos fills the entire frame. And then what I'm gonna do in each of these photos is I'm gonna make sure that the building aligns in all of the photos. To do that, you bring the next photo over the previous photo, then you go to effects controls, and then you bring down the opacity. And then what you do is you go over to position and scale, and you just make sure that each building overlaps perfectly on top of the previous one. I would probably bring the opacity down to like 50% just so you can see it clearly. After everything is aligned, you bring the opacity back up to 100%. You bring the clip back in front of the previous clip, and then you start moving on to the next clip and you do the exact same thing. After you're finished, you press play and this is what you get. In order to make this go on for a little bit longer, what you're probably going to do is highlight all the photos and you're going to nest them. Then click OK. Then after that, put your playhead at the end and then copy using Control C or Command C on a Mac. Then you're going to do Command V to paste. And what that's going to do is it's going to just continuously copy that same sequence of photos over and over again. And it therefore makes your hyperlapse even longer. And that's it, guys.
Even though every photo is taken from a different part of the city, Premiere Pro makes it feel like one continuous shot. As you can see, Photoshop sold the movement and then Premiere Pro sold the illusion.